Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing revision of chapter 13 and in that row till last video we have finished with exercise 13.3 conversion part. How we will converse from a smaller unit into a bigger unit or from a bigger unit into smaller unit that we have seen in our last class. Now, according to area means when we are talking about like 1 square meter, 1 square centimeter, 1 square millimeter, that will be there. Square meter means, or square millimeter or square centimeter means when 1 centimeter will be multiplied by the same. Like 1 centimeter will be multiplied by 1 centimeter, then that will become square centimeter. And if I talk about the area, then we were taking its length also and breadth also in terms of rectangle. And if I talk about square, then again we are taking both the side multiplied by side. So today simply we are going to find it out area of a rectangle and square by using formulas. Based on formula, we are going to find it out. We are going to do questions related to how to find area of a rectangle as well as of a square. So children, let's start with the formula. Now, first of all, about rectangle. Now, let's say if you have a room and that room floor is in shape of a rectangle. You have a room and in that room the floor is it in the form of rectangle. Now this longer side will become length and this shorter side will become breadth. Now if I have to put carpet over this area, or in this room, so what do we require here? We required here that how much area will be occupied by this carpet. So here I am talking about area of this floor which is having length also and breadth also. So I need a formula which, or I need a product of this length and breadth which will tell us that how many square meter, how many square centimeter carpet is required to cover this particular area. So what we are going to write here, area of a rectangle. Simply here I am not going to mention that what is the floor. Floor is in the shape of a rectangle and then I required this formula, area of a rectangle, that is length multiplied by breadth. Fine. You can write in this form only L into B. Now, if that particular room is in the shape of a square, again, you want to put carpet in this area. Now, you know the property of a square. What is the property of a square? That all four sides of a square is same. Side is same. All the four sides are same. So what will be the formula of area of a square? So we'll write this area of a square. Area of a square. That will be product of two sides, S into S. That is side multiplied by side. So what do we understand here? That area of a rectangle, here we are talking about carpeting a floor and that floor is in the shape of a rectangle, then we will multiply length into breadth, L into B, then area of a square, that will be product of its sides, S into S. So that is your formula which we are going to use today in the questions to find it out, area of a rectangle and area of a square. So children, let's start with a question. Now, what is the question here? क्वेश्चन नंबर टू कैलकुलेट क्वेश्चन नंबर टू ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 13.3 कैलकुलेट द एरिया ऑफ द रेक्टेंगल हूज लेंथ इज इक्वल टू 20 meters एंड ब्रेथ इज 11 meters So for doing this question number 2, A part, length is given to you, that is 20 meters and breadth is given, that is, breadth is 11 meters. So how we are going to do this? We know the formula, area of a rectangle, what is the formula here? Area of a rectangle, that is, L into B, length into breadth. Then what we are going to do it in this, we'll put this value 20 multiplied by 11. Now again meter will multiplied will meter, then meter into meter that will become square meter or meter square. So that will become 11, 2s are 22, 220 square meter. That will be unit of area. Many of times children skip formula, they know this formula, that's why only they were doing this multiplication, but they don't remember to write that formula. Second thing, they don't remember to write this unit. Even here also they were writing 20 meter multiplied by 11 meter, but when they have to write this unit finally, then they skip it. So that is very important. Area of a rectangle, the formula is L into B, length into breadth. We'll put this value 20 into 11 and then do the multiplication, 220 square meter. Meter square or square meter, that is very important, that is unit of length. Now we'll talk about the next, that is next question. What will happen if you have been given one in meter or centimeter and other was in, one is in meter? So what we will do in this case, B part, let's see how we will do it. Now this formula is common in all the question, that I'm not erasing it. I'm going to erase only this part, meter, this and this. Okay. So now B part, the length is given, that is 5 meters 50 centimeters. 5 meters 50 centimeters. Now, can you write this 5 meters 50 centimeters into one more way? Yes. We can write it as 5.5 meters. We can convert this 50 centimeters. How? We know in 1 meter we have 100 centimeters. So here 50 will be divided by 100. So that will become 0.50. That will be added in 5.5 meter, and breadth will be 2 meter. Breadth is already in meter. Breadth you don't require to convert it. Breadth is already in meter, that you don't require to convert it. So length is 5.5 meter. So 5.5 meter will be multiplied by 2 meter. 2 5s are 10, 2 5s are 10, 11, 11.0 meter square. So that will be your answer in this case. Find area of a rectangle is equals to L into B, 5.5 meter into 2 meter. So we'll do this multiplication, 2 5s are 10, 1 2 5s are 10, 11, 11.0 meter square or square meter. Both the units are correct. You can write this unit or in this unit. Both are correct. So that is question number 2, how to calculate area of the rectangle whose length and breadth will be given. Now similarly, C part is there, length is 70 centimeter and breadth is 7.5 centimeter. If you have any doubt in multiplication, like how we have to do multiplication of decimal, you just leave the decimal, simply do the multiplication and after that put the decimal. See how? 7 7s are 49. 0 5 9 3 12 5. So after one decimal place, this will be your area. 525.0. So that will be there. Okay. Now in decimal, whenever you have to do multiplication, you leave the decimal, do the multiplication. After doing multiplication, then put the decimal over there. Fine. That is one of the way to avoid mistakes. And if you are quite sure, then you can do the multiplication with the decimal. But in between, you are not going to put anywhere decimal. Decimal will be put it at last only. So that is question number 2, C part. I hope that is quite easy. You all can do it. And question number 3, let's start question number 3, in which you have to calculate the area of the squares whose side is given, that is 6 mm, 10 meter and 110 centimeter. So it's quite easy in case of a square, because side into side you do not having two different unit like in this question, that one part of the question will be in meter or centimeter or other part will be in meter. So there is no chance of confusion. In square you have the same side, that will only multiply it twice. So quite simple question number 3. Let's start question number 3. We'll do it one or two question here, and after that you will complete that question in your revision. Question number 3, that is calculate area of a square whose side is, now what is the side given, that is 6 mm. The first one only we are going to take it, 6 mm. Now what is the formula for finding area of a square? Let's write it. Area of a square, what is the formula? That is side into side, side multiplied by side. So we'll do it. 6 mm will be multiplied by 6 mm, that will become 6 6 will be 36, square millimeter, 36 square millimeter, that is your area of a square. S into S, 6 millimeter multiplied by 6 millimeter, 6 6 are 36 square millimeter. So that is your question number 3. Quite simple. The next one is 10 meter. You can multiply 10 multiplied by 10. 10 tens are will be 100. Meter will become square meter. 110 centimeter, 110 centimeter multiplied by 110 centimeter. Do the multiplication. What you will get it? 121 and then two zeros will be square centimeter. Fine. Quite easy question. Quite simple way, simple formula, area of a square, that is side into side. Do the multiplication and simply you can get that formula and you can get the answer of that question. So this question 2 and 3 again, it is quite easy. Now let's talk about question number 4. Let's see how you will do question number 4. A room is 6 meter 15 centimeter long. Now length of a room is given, that is 6 meter 15 centimeter, and breadth of a room, that is 250 centimeter. Find the area of the floor of the room. That only I was talking about just few minutes back, that if you have if you want to put carpet in your room, then you are going to find it out what is the carpet area of the floor. That only will be included, and that carpet area will be used to find it out its area of that particular room. Okay, length and breadth, that we have to see only. Now 6 meter 15 centimeter, just now I have told you how to find it out how to do conversion from centimeter into meter. But since here the breadth is given in centimeter, what you are going to do, you will convert the length also in centimeter. See how. So let's start question number 4 and we'll understand question number 4 first very in a quite good manner. That question number 4, what is that question number 4? Length of a room. Length of a room or length of a room or a floor of a room. Length of a room is 6 meter 15 centimeter. Now can you convert this 6 meter and 15 centimeter into centimeter? Yes, it is possible. Because we know in 1 meter we have 100 centimeter. So that will become 6 will be multiplied by 100 plus 15. That will be 600 plus 15. 615 centimeter. Then breadth of a room. Breadth of a room. That is 250 centimeter. Now what we have got? We have got length also which is in centimeter and breadth also which is there in centimeter. Now what we have to find it out here? Area. Area of the floor you have to find it out. Now one thing which you have to keep it in your mind which is very important, that both the length and breadth will be in same unit when you are doing the multiplication. Either you will change centimeter into meter or meter into centimeter, means only one unit is required. Area of a room. Formula will be length multiplied by breadth. We'll do this multiplication. 615 multiplied by 250. Centimeter will do this multiplication and then we will get the answer. Now, is there any problem in multiplication? Let me know in online class and then only we can clear that doubt of multiplication. Here simply 615 three digit multiplication we have already done. That will be multiplied by this. And then you will get the answer and answer we will write in square centimeter. Because here we were talking about the area. Square centimeter means here we were talking about the area. So that answer you will be writing in square centimeter. Fine. So what we have seen in this question? In this question we have seen how to find it out area of the floor of the room if length or length and breadth is given to you. You know the formula for finding in case of length or breadth will be given. We'll write this length of a room. 6 meter 15 centimeter. Now 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. That will be multiplied by 6 will be multiplied by 100. 600 plus 15. That will be 615 centimeter. Now breadth of a room, that is 250 centimeter. Area of a room, that is L into B. 615 will be multiplied by 250. Do this multiplication and then you will get the answer. Quite simple question, but the only thing which you have to keep it in your mind, that is length and breadth. Many times I am repeating the same thing, that length and breadth must be in same unit when you are doing the multiplication and finding the area of that particular room. These both length and breadth will be in same unit. See here, a meter and centimeter will be given. That's why we have converted this meter part. 6 will be multiplied by 100, 615 centimeter. Because we required, because breadth is already given in centimeter. So, either you can convert it into meter. So, that will be in decimal. Then you have to do the multiplication in decimal. The same thing will be there. Then answer you will be getting is square meter. And in this way you will be getting answer in square centimeter. So we'll do this. 615 will be multiplied by 250, and then we will write this answer in square centimeter. That is your question number 4. Now question number 5. Find the area of a square field whose each side is 85 meter. Now talking about area of a square. Area of a square is quite simple. We know the properties of a square. All the four sides of a square is equal. So here, whenever you have to find it out, area of a square, you simply use that formula, side multiplied by side, and then you will put that value. So that is your formula, 6 meter. Question number 5, that is find the area of a square field whose each side is 85 meter. 85 meter means one side is 85 meter. So we'll put that value, side into side. Put that value is 85 meter multiplied by 85 meter, and then you will be getting that answer. Now question number 5 will do it, that find the area of a square field whose each side is 85 meter. So let's start that question number 5. Now side of a square, side of a square field, or yes. So what we are going to write, the first statement, question number 5. Side of a square field. That is 85 meter. Then area of a square field. We know the formula for this. Yes, we know the formula for this, that is side multiplied by side. We'll do this multiplication. 85 meter will be multiplied by 85 meter. Do this multiplication and then you will get the answer. Let's see the multiplication also. 85 will be multiplied by 85. 5 fives are, that will be 25. We'll write here 5, 2 will be carry. 5 8s are 40 and 2, 42. Then 8 5s are 44. 8 8s are 64 and 4, 68. The sum is 5, 2, 2, 7. So here the answer will be 7,225 square meter. 7,225 square meter. That will be there. 7,225 square meter. 7,225 square meter. So that is your question number 5. How to find the area of a square field whose each side is 85 meter. So in this way you have to find it out. Area of a square field whose each side is 85 meter. Now let's come to area of a square field. Is quite simple formula, because we know all the four sides of a square is equal. So the formula is in same kind of that, side into side, side multiplied by side. Whatever length of one side is given, that will be multiplied by the same. Now come to question number 6. Now this question number 6 is related to comparison of an angle. That how do you compare area of two different figures? See how a rectangle, which is bigger in area, a rectangle 13 meter in length and 9 meter in breadth, or a square of 12 meter side. Now you can see here length of a rectangle is bigger. See here, area of a rectangle, what we are going to write it. Question number 6. We have to find it out. Now, what we have to do it in this question? Area of a rectangle, we have to find it out. After that, we have to find it out area of a square. And then we have to compare that out of these two, which one is big in area or whose area is bigger. Let's see how. First of all, area of a rectangle we are going to find it out. Area of a rectangle. What is the formula now? Formula is length multiplied by breadth. Length multiplied by breadth. So we'll do it 13 meter multiplied by 9 meter. 9 threes are 27, 117 square meter. Now you have been given with a square also. So we will find it out area of a square whose side is, what is the side given? That is 12 meter. That is 12 meter. Formula will write side multiplied by side. So we'll do this multiplication. 12 meter multiplied by 12 meter. That is 144 square meter. 144 square meter. Now whose area is bigger? Can you compare now? Area of a rectangle. Although length of the longer side is bigger. The longer side of this rectangle is 13 meter. And here all the four sides is 12 meter. Since the area of a square is bigger. So you will write therefore area of a square. Area of a square is bigger. Is bigger. You are going to write this question. You are going to write this solution sentence, whose area is bigger? So you will tell that yes, because here the area of a square is 144 centimeter a square meter, and area of a rectangle, that is 117 square meter. So yes, whose area is bigger? That is yes, area of a square is bigger than a rectangle. So that is question number 6, that is related to comparison of a rectangle. Comparison of a rectangle. Now which is bigger in area? A rectangle is given and then a square is given. You have to tell that which of the following is bigger in area. So with this we have finished this question number 6. So let's revise that what we have done in today's class. This is the last question of today's class, that is related to comparison of area of a rectangle and then area of a square. And then you are going to find it out, yes, whose area is bigger. Now, before that we have done how to calculate area of a rectangle, how to calculate area of a square. After that, how to find it out area of a rectangle or square in terms of when we come to questions. Now after this, after once you will understand how to calculate their areas using formula, then we will talk about that how much cost of that flooring carpet or carpeting of that floor or painting of that floor or painting of that wall, whosoever length or breadth will be there. So that question we are going to take it in tomorrow's class. Till today we have finished till question number 6, and you all will do practice of these 6 questions. Tomorrow we will take it up next questions of this exercise 13.3. Fine. So tomorrow we will start with our next question of that same exercise, that is 7. Still 4 questions are left from this exercise, that is 7, 8, 9 and 10. That we will take it in tomorrow's class. After that we will start with the next topic, that is volume. How to find it out volume. Fine. volume again another new concept that we will see in the next class. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.